You hear a lot about the income disparity here in Egypt, but in recent years, this country's economy has really been booming. One of the architects of the economic policy was Rashid Mohammed Rashid. He was most recently Minister of Trade and Industry here in Egypt. He was asked to join the new administration, but refused. Since that time, he's been in Dubai. He joins us from Dubai right now. Welcome to In Business, Minister. It's lovely to have you on the show. I want to ask you, you told us that these protests set Egypt back 10 years economically. Do you still believe that?
Well, unfortunately, we face a situation now after the events where the interruption in doing business is hurting the Egyptian economy. We have seen some significant slowdown in production. We are seeing a lot of strikes, and we are seeing a lot of interruption in production in many aspects, including banks, including financial institutions. We need, of course, to resume the confidence of the investors and the operators in Egypt very quickly, and that's exactly what we need to focus on for the period to come. But in the meantime, there is a damage that has happened, and I think the job of the government now is to try to minimize that damage as much as possible.
Well, what aid would you ask the international community for, the IMF, the World Bank, to try to get the economy up and running again?
Well, we think that the whole world should be supporting Egypt in the period to come. What have happened in Egypt is positive, and I think there is a positive side to it in the medium and long term. But in the short term, we need the support of the rest of the world. I already engaged in some negotiation here in the Gulf with some of the governments, some of the companies. We see at least three areas where they could make a difference. One, we would like governments in the region here to engage with their investors in Egypt to compensate them for any damages, whether physical or indirect, to ensure that they do not reduce any investment or get rid of any employments. The second factor, we would like some of the funds in the region here to pump money into the stock market of Egypt. Egypt is a great economy. I think in the long term, things will recover and exceed anybody's expectations. So an encouragement of pumping money into the stock market of Egypt is a very positive step. Third and most important, we want to continue to see the flow of investment coming in. So I am encouraging a dialogue with the government on some of the projects to make sure that we will see a continuation of flow of investment, especially now with a new Egypt emerging after this event.
Minister, we know about the economic growth that you helped engineer. Why was distribution of wealth such a problem for the Mubarak regime?
Well, definitely this is one of the challenges. We have already started some time ago a program to improve the distribution of wealth, whether categorically or geographically, where we should go into governorates and areas of Egypt which are less wealthy and more deprived. The other element is that we want to make sure that also through the improvement of the tax system, there is a better distribution of wealth, especially when we introduce the real estate tax and the programs to move into a VAT tax. We wanted more and more now a better distribution, not only of the revenues, but also of the opportunities for investment as well as the opportunities for employment. This is something that we must see that continue in Egypt. But before that, there are five things that we need to see now, Margaret. One, law and order in the street. Second, we want stability in Egypt. Mm-hmm. Third, we want the government to state clearly their business-friendly environment, the smooth transition in the next few months, and a clear vision of what Egypt will be economically in the years to come.
Sir, when you walk around the streets of Cairo and you talk to people, they think that this former regime was a kleptocracy. That is to say, they think former members of the administration actually took money out of this country. They feel robbed. What do you say to those people? You know these ministers, you've worked with them. How would you respond to that?
Well, I believe that Egypt, like many other countries, of course, we have a certain level of corruption. And I think our ministry and our cabinet was trying very hard to reduce the level of corruption, especially when it comes to many aspects of the business environment. We have put in place anti-monopoly law. We have increased the value of land. We have worked on the equation about energy and gas and oil prices. Many of the ministers that were in this government were trying very hard to create anti-corruption environment. There might be some incidents, there might be some cases. Of course, with a revolution, there will be a lot of suspicion. But I'm sure with the judiciary system in Egypt, the courts in Egypt, things will be cleared. All what I want is people to understand that the future will be better, to focus on building and creating value instead of going into a mood of taking revenge.
So we have to leave it there, but very quickly, do you know anything more about whether you are once again allowed to travel, whether you can return to Egypt?
Sorry, I couldn't hear you. Could you repeat that?
Can you return to Egypt yet?
Well, I am going to return to Egypt. I'm coordinating with the Office of the General Prosecutor. He will advise me when to come back to Egypt, but Egypt is my country. I'm going back to Egypt, and whatever charges, whatever issues there, I'm very confident. I'm confident about myself, about the realities, about the facts, and I'm sure that all the things will be cleared very quickly.
All right, Minister Rashid, thank you very much for joining us live from Dubai.